So recently I made a video about Mystic POD, this one right here. It's an AI app that's built specifically for print on demand. Now it's still in beta, but I'm gonna show you exactly what it can do right now. I'm sure it's gonna get better and better in the future, and how I would use it for print on demand currently if you have a subscription. I'm gonna go from beginning to end, from creating a design and uploading it to Amazon in my case, but you can use this to upload it to your Shopify store or Etsy or wherever. So whatever print on demand you're doing. So I think this will be very valuable. The last video I did was kind of everything that it did. This time I'm gonna go step by step and show you how kind of the workflow that you would use when using Mystic right now when it's in beta. All right, so here we are on Mystic, mysticpod.com. You can see it's still in beta. You can actually try Mystic for free right here by clicking on here. I have to still log in, so I'm gonna do that, and then I'll show you what to do next. So once I've logged in, you can see these are the things that I've been working on. I've been playing with it for a little while here. What you wanna do, you may not have these yet if you're just starting out, so you're gonna go to the templates page. This is the default page that everybody will see once they start, because they wouldn't have anything that they're working on. And then what I would do is, if you're first doing this, I would just pick one of these that you like, and then we can kind of remix it, right? So if you want text designs, if you want t-shirt designs, for example, you can come in here and you can see all the different styles of t-shirt designs. Let's say you want retro vintage t-shirt designs, they have that too. And you can go in here and look at it, right? All right, so next thing I'm going to do is, let's see, let's try this Colorado one. I've seen these before, they do pretty well. I'm just going to click on here. And what you can do is, the power of Mystic is that you can take something that's already done and remix it. So that, you know, people could download this and use this, but you want something different, something new. And so that's what the remix feature is right here. So I'm gonna remix this. And another thing that I really like is that there's 6 credits each, but if I do 8, I can do 8 at a time and then change out. So let's see, I want a black background, make sure, and change out the state for different states in the USA. All right, so I can put a prompt like that, and it's just gonna know, like, I don't want it all of them to say Colorado, right? We're gonna have a different one. I'm gonna say different states near the Rocky Mountains, just so we can have, let's see if the AI is that smart, near the Rocky Mountains in the USA. So Colorado, Wyoming, Utah, all of those. So let's see what happens. So after hitting remix, you're gonna see it go to that page right here. So you can see it's doing 8 at a time, which is crazy. So I can do scaled designs. I can take all of these and put them on Amazon or Etsy or your own Shopify store. It may be different enough to make them on TeePublic and Redbubble, but you need to be careful about scaled designs on those. They don't like doing all that. So look at new, like Idaho, Montana, Nevada, Arizona, Utah, New Mexico, yeah. Those are Rocky Mountain states, pretty cool. All right, and you can see they're slightly different, so they're not necessarily all scaled designs, but they are on black backgrounds, and I'm gonna just do some bulk edit things. So this is another really cool thing about Mystic, is I can click on all of these and edit them, or do some bulk actions, not really edit, on them. So I could remix all of these again, I could remove the background, which we're gonna do, and then upscale it. I'm not gonna vectorize it, which I could, but then I'm gonna download it. So I'm gonna use a lot of these. I'm gonna remove the background first. Let's see, yes, remove them. I can do it on all 8 at once. And the nice thing about this is it's gonna show you when it's done. So you can see here, this one's already done, and it's removing the black background as well as the black in the mountains. This one didn't quite do it, but I think that's probably because that's not quite black. So we're gonna see some, yeah, so this one had all black on here. So I believe this one's gonna get knocked out and so on. So let's see how it looks like. Yeah, really cool, right? So now when this is put on a black t-shirt or a dark t-shirt, that's gonna get knocked out. So some of them didn't work out so well. So one of the things you can do also is delete on here. So you can pick some that you don't like. So that's the nice thing about doing all of these. So I'm gonna the ones that didn't actually turn out the way I wanted, I'm gonna unselect these, and this one didn't turn out, and this one didn't turn out, that's fine. I can take my bulk actions, and I can actually delete that if I wanted to. I'm gonna do it here just to show you. I may not wanna do that. I may wanna keep it and kinda refine it, but let's see. Just to show you that you can delete those. Okay, next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take all of these that I did here, and I'm gonna do another action, and that is upscale. So now it's gonna be the right size. I'm gonna upscale that to about 4,000 by 4,000, and I'm gonna show you that it's the right size now, and I don't have to like scale it up in another app. So typically, if you did an AI thing like ChatGPT, I use that, and Leonardo sometimes, I'm not sure if they have an upscaler, Ideogram, you'll have to go to another app to upscale it. But this one actually does it for you. It does it four times, so just above 4,000 by 4,000. I'm gonna show you what that looks like after it's all done. And another thing that I like is that it actually shows you that it's working on it, so you know with the check mark, yes, it did that action that it did. So in this case, the upscale. So last thing we're gonna do after this is all done is we're gonna download all of these, and I'll show you what that is like. Okay, so we're all selected again, bulk actions. I'm gonna hit download and download. I'm gonna do the Excel spreadsheet. I didn't do that in my last video, I just did the designs. I'm gonna show you the difference here and why this could be helpful for print on demand. So I'm gonna hit that. It's gonna be really quick. It's right there, it did it. I'm gonna pull it up to show you what's in this Excel spreadsheet. All right, so here's the Excel spreadsheet. I'm gonna take these so you can see what's in each of them. I'm gonna just stretch it out so you can see. That was the prompt that I used. B, base prompt, it didn't have one. C, prompt AI, this is pretty cool right here. If you need to use that prompt for whatever reason, you can see it did a long prompt there. This is the original, this is a link to the original design that it made. This is the link to the upscaled. I didn't upscale those two, remember that, didn't do that. And this is for the no background. So it did no background and then it upscaled the no background. And this is vectorized, which I didn't do. And then this is the title that you can use in your designs. And this is the description if you want to use that in your design. And here's some tags, which is really helpful. Now I'm going to use some of these tags in my title because I think like, if you want a short title, this is great, but I'm gonna use Amazon, which can handle longer titles, so I'm gonna use some of that. So this is a great resource, so you don't have to think about any of those things. All right, so the next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this Nevada one right here. I'm gonna go back to the Excel spreadsheet, bring it up here. Whoops, bring it up twice. So this one, Nevada, there, that one right there. I'm gonna scroll over. I shouldn't have stretched this out so much. And see where I'm at. So I can click original image, but I want the upscaled one. So this one right here. So it's the upscaled one, it looks great. I'm gonna bring this or save this and just drag it down onto my desktop right here. It is a WEBP file, so I can't just take this and put it onto print on demand. So I'm gonna have to go and use something else, which is Photopea, and we're gonna open that up and I'll show you what to do in there. Just a little bit of an adjustment and change it to a PNG and it should be fine. All right, so here I am on Photopea, photopea.com. I'm just gonna drag in that WEBP, you can see right there, and we'll see what size it is. I'm gonna come up here and look at image, canvas size. You can see it's 496 by 496, which is big enough, but I'm gonna just change that so you can see 4,500 by 5,400. You don't actually have to do it this size anymore for Amazon, but I like doing it, so I'm gonna do that. And then we can see the transform control tools are off by default. I changed it, put it on myself because I like that, so I can make it bigger. So if I did wanna make it bigger, that's fine. And it's just a little bit bigger, so I don't have to be worried that it's gonna pixelate because I'm not taking it from 1029 to 4500, I'm taking it from 40 to 45, right? So not too bad. And I'm gonna do place it where I want it. So if I want to put it up higher like this, that's fine. And I can center it just like that. I can zoom out here and kind of show you where it is on the 4500 by 5400 if I want it higher. I can do that. But this is kind of, if you've ever done these before, the 4500 by 5400, you kind of know where to put it kind of more up top on here, unless it's taller, because you want to put it around the chest area of the t-shirt. So now that it's in the right spot, I'm going to export this. I'll go File, Export As, PNG, PNG, yep, 4500 by 5400, and I can name it. I can just name it Nevada and PNG and hit Save. All right, I'm pretty sure it saved it. Yes, it's on my downloads. And here it is, all ready to go. I'm gonna take this PNG that I just made and go to Amazon and I'll show you how it works. So here I am on Amazon Merch On Demand. Now you can use this PNG in any capacity on any print on demand site, Redbubble, TeePublic, whatever. But I'm just gonna show you here to show you that it actually works, because it has to be an RGB, PNG and everything. I'm just gonna grab that PNG, pull it into here. You can see it's spinning, which means it works. And let's see what it looks like on the different colors on here. And I can put it on any of the dark colors, because remember, the mountain got knocked out. So look at that. It's pretty cool, right? And I can put it on different products. I can even put it on the new tumblers. Now, if you want it black here on these pillows, you're going to have to just pick black. But I think that turned out great. Look at that. Pop sockets as well on here. You just move it and slide it. So it's big enough to fit on all of these products. You can make it bigger on the hoodie as well, so you can see that it fits perfect on there. So there you go. That's how easy it is to take these. And remember, I made a bunch of these at once. I made 8 of them. I took out 2, so 6. But look how fast that was, and I can put it on all of these. And oh, the titles. So let's change this and this. So I'll go back to that Excel. So right here, whoops. So that was Nevada. So this was the prompt, but remember there was titles here. So if I want to do Retro Nevada, I can do that, copy that, put it right here. Let me switch back to that again. I probably should have hold it up here. This is the description. I can copy that. Let me move this here just a little bit, and I can put it in the description here. It's already written for me. And then remember, we also had the tags. Yes, the tags. So we got these tags. Now, I wouldn't use the tags in the title just like how they are, but I'm gonna put them in the brand here just so we can have them. So I'm gonna say Retro Nevada Vintage Style. You see what I'm doing? I think it's a Vintage Sunset too, so I'm gonna do Vintage Sunset Style Mountain Graphic, yep. And that's how I'd write the title, by using these keywords. And then I could use the brand. Now, the brand, I wouldn't do Nevada, because we're gonna put a bunch of different ones under this brand. So I would do like Vintage Sunset Graphic Design USA States or something like that, right? And then I would hit Publish. So make sure that everything's done before you hit publish. You don't wanna put that on white. You're gonna have to change all of these colors to black. Make sure that everything's in the right spot. Make sure you choose all the colors and everything. It's fine for youth, but yeah, that's it. You got your design title, brand, product description. If you wanna do bullets and things like that, you could use this as well to kinda help with your bullets. Make sure your bullets have all the keywords that were on here to help you. So yeah, that's how easy it is. I like this feature that it has the descriptions and tags for you, so you don't have to think about it. But you can add more, of course, on here. And there you go. That's how easy it is to use Mystic POD to do print on demand stuff, mainly t-shirts. There you go, pretty quick video on Mystic POD. You can see the power of it, that you can scale it really quickly. If you want to learn more about Mystic POD, I have that video again, like I said. I'll put a link in the description as well as an affiliate code if you plan on using it. I know it, with the beta, they're doing a lot of good deals right now, especially around the Q4 time. That's probably never going to be as a good of a deal as it is now because it's Q4 and it's in beta, so you could probably get the best deal ever. So check it out. You can try it for free and try what I just did on Mystic POD. So hopefully this video is really helpful for you. Thanks again for watching. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one.